Okay, hey everybody, I am back with another video, and be just candid with you all. I really don't feel like doing this video because I'm not feeling my best, but I'm trying to stick to my weekly updates, so that's what it is. This video may not be long because I feel like I'm going to be kind of rushing through it because, like I said, I'm not really feeling my myself. I'm not feeling like I usually do. So this is my 24-week pregnancy update. And so if you saw my last video, I believe it was mentioned in my last video, that my breast had started leaking. It was twice that it happened. Well, lo and behold, that leaking was on the verge of something serious. And when I say that, I'm talking about, if I pronounce it right, I'll have it in the description and the definition of it. But it was on the verge of me having mastitis. I probably said it wrong, but it's like M-A-S-T-I-S, I mean T-I-T-I-S or something like that. But like I said, I have it in the description. But it's something that women can get when their milk supply comes in after they had the baby and they're producing so much milk where basically the baby is not keeping up, or you'll have to start pumping. And of course it will cause you, a woman, to get engorged and begin to have clogged milk ducts. Well, I started having some symptoms of the breast infection. I'm not going to keep saying the word because I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing it wrong. But like I said, I have it in the description. But I started having symptoms of it, and I also had Googled it because just to make sure of what I knew. So what had happened was, I want to say the very next day after I had recorded my last video, that next day, going into the night, I was feeling, on my right side, I was feeling real tender and soreness there, which I kind of wasn't expecting that to be unusual, because you know that can happen where your breast gets tender and sore during the pregnancy. So I didn't think much of it. I had went to sleep, and I was woken up out of my sleep because of how painful it was feeling. And it was only my right side, the same side that I was had previously leaked twice, where it was leakage twice. So I woke up, it was probably about 2:15 in the morning, and it was very painful. I couldn't even move my right arm because it was very, very, very painful. Like, no cap, it was very painful. And so I got up, went to the restroom because I also had to use the bathroom. So I got up, went to the restroom, and I just started applying a warm, well, pretty hot compress. So I just got a washcloth, and I would wet it with really hot water, wring it out, and I kept pressing it up against my breast and trying to massage where I felt, where it kind of felt like it was a lump, and feeling kind of like a knot a little bit, and feeling very tender. So I had did that probably for like a good 15-20 minutes, just kept re-wetting the washcloth and reapplying it and trying to massage it, but it was so painful to try to massage it. So I finally came out of the restroom, I took one Tylenol, and I had got in my heating pad, and I had the heating pad I think set on medium, I think I did, and I just laid the heating pad on my breast because I didn't want to keep like getting up to re-wetting the washcloth. So I just kept the heating pad on it the remainder of the night. It was very hard for me to sleep. I didn't get much sleep. I kind of had myself like propped up where I was pretty much like almost sitting up and just trying to get comfortable as much as possible. But it lasts, that pain lasted for about a good day. It did start to subside like very little, and I think it came from the heating pad, and then I only took one Tylenol. But later on that day I had took a second one because I know you can, or at least I was, have been told by my doctor that I can take Tylenol, but I don't even be trying to take Tylenol like that. So if I do take a Tylenol, I usually take one at the sign of, you know, a headache or discomfort, whatever I'm feeling, I would just take one. So it started to like gradually subside for that whole like a good 24-hour period. And then into the next day, it had eased up a great deal of it. But I didn't really think that you can have a breast infection before like your milk really comes in or whatever. So that took me by surprise. But it was just that one time, that one night that I was in a lot of pain, and I was just like, if it don't get no better, then I was like, you know, I really don't want to try to go to the ER with, you know, with this pandemic and everything. So I was trying to toughen it out, and thank goodness it was gradually starting to go away. But it was like a good 24-hour period. Like, it was very sore and tender, and it would hurt for me to like move my arm because your milk ducts are, and milk glands are like in your armpit area, and then they come this way. So it hurt for me to like move my arm and to do things and stuff like that. So I was just like, I hope this doesn't happen again. But it was just that one time that that following day that I said my breast was leaking, that into that night in a 24-hour period, my breast, well, just the right one, was in a lot of pain. Something else that happened within a week's time, I have revisit constipation. At least twice, which that's no fun. My eating is still the same, no cravings. Those were like the two main things that happened. Not anything like really different. Still feel, you know, a lot of movement from the baby. And yeah, like I said, no cravings. I haven't had any headaches. That was pretty much the two things that was going on within this week's time. So I have my appointment coming up next week. So, like I said, after I go to that appointment, I will also include that in my update for next week. That's pretty much it. The time is going by really fast, and before I know it, this baby's gonna be here. And I feel like, as I speak, like I'm having a Braxton Hicks contraction because my belly has hardened up and it's really tight, and it feels like a cramp, like a mild, like menstrual cramp, and it's starting to ease up. So Okay, so I actually had a breastfeeding contraction. haven't really had any of those. So that's about it. So I don't have nothing else to say. I'm hungry. I had the laundry earlier today, so I'm tired from that. I'm about to eat me a late lunch because I don't know what time it is. It's like 3 or 4. I lost track of time. But that's it. I'm gonna show y'all my bump and we out of here. So I hope I don't knock this over because I have it sitting like on this box here. So y'all are kind of close, but it's whatever. So not much change in my belly, so that's what it's looking like. And like I said, I'm carrying low weight. My belly sits down here. Well, for my baby, feel something right there. But that is it. That's all I got going on. So I hope you all got something from this video. If you want, you can give it a like, a comment, and subscribe. If not, that's cool too. And until next time. Peace.